So, hello everyone. My name is Thomas Reuter and I'm working at the Archaeological Heritage Office of Saxony in Dresden for the last several years. And there I'm using a wide range of close range sensors for different applications in our house. And today I will present you two projects from there. There's an increasing use of monitoring and measurements of processes in cultural institutions. Examples like the preserved ships in Scandinavia and the German Maritime Museum in Bremerhaven are showing the importance of monitoring projects to detect changes in size and shape, as we heard in the ship sessions yesterday. After a short general section, I would like to talk about two current projects at our office. And as a consequence, some minds about the question, is this application an appropriate solution for loans? Here you can see an extreme example from Thuringia, where permanent monitoring is an important aspect to guarantee public safety. You see, it's a little bit out of vertical, slightly more than Pisa. And although our projects are, of course, not so life-threatening, but the task is completely the same as here. So, but what does monitoring mean within the context of surveying? And in engineering surveying, monitoring will be defined as follows. The purpose of monitoring is to detect changes in position and height of an examined object in relation to its surroundings and or its deformations and as a function of time. So object changes in size and shape, in other words, its deformations, can be caused by external or inner forces, temperature, humidity, shocks or torsions are generating strong forces and thus possibly unwanted changes of buildings, as you've seen before, or of course of exhibits if we think about it smaller scales. So the preservation process always means heavy stress for an organic object. Excavation, cleaning, treatment, and drying, of course, creating such strong forces. Since 2005, the 3D documentation of archaeological finds is well established as an own department in our house. Four 3D scanners are in use, which have been procured through the years. You see here the family. And currently, the mobile scanner, Arctic Eva, and the both smart scans are mainly in use, while the old Kunika Minolta, it's the gray thing here, can be shared by colleagues or students who would like to scan their objects by their own. But let us come to the first long-term project where 3D scanning and monitoring are important topics. With 2012, a comprehensive investigation of medieval mines in the Ore Mountains, which we will find, well, here, was started as an EU-funded project. A follow-on project was launched in 2015 and will end in August this year. Archeo Montan is an interdisciplinary binational German-Czech project which focused on the southern area of Saxony and the northern Bohemia. And for further information and some news and so on, please feel free to visit our website here. Here you see a typical situation beneath the town of Diepoldiswalde, especially the limited space. You can imagine it here, imagine here in the black hole. Makes it difficult to proceed archaeological documentation of the mines, which are dated to the 12th and 13th century. It's dark, it's cold and wet, so we find ideal conditions for an excellent conservation status here. At the same time, reinforcement work is taking place by the Bergsicherung. In English, we would say mountain assurance, maybe, but the German mining speech is sometimes a little bit strange, so I don't know the right English words, sorry. And after the reinforcement work, all shafts will be filled with concrete. So our task is that the documentation has to be finished as fast as possible, but is also as accurate and complete as possible, because after refilling, the shafts are sealed forever. A recent excavation you see here on this slide, this is a part of a giant water wheel, and this brown thing here is its shaft. So the whole water wheel has had a diameter of 15 meters, and the shaft itself here had a diameter of 90 centimeters with a with a length of probably 6 meters. So we estimated a weight of more than 1.5 tons. So yeah. So and it's in a depth of 30 meters. Every wood was measured by total stations, structure for motion, and the Arctic EVA, and the data will be used for documentation as well for the future 3D reconstruction of the reel after all parts will be fine scanned by the structured light scanners in our office in Dresden. After the documentation, the installation around the shaft, these planks here and these things here, were disassembled and excavated. And this should show only an example which dimensions our finds could have in Saxony. On this slide you see a selection of smaller finds, like a small lamp here or a shovel. So as a standard, the wooden finds will be transported to our conservation department, then cleaned and scanned by our high-resolution scanners. This data will be used as reconstructions and publications while the original finds are preserved. So here's a view of our conservation department. After the scanning, the conservation treatment will follow as soon as possible using polyethylene glycol 2000. It's only a thing for our conservators here. As the next step, the impregnated fines will be freeze-dried, and this is exactly where forces affecting object's geometry. All dried fines will be scanned again, followed by a target actual comparison. The deviation analysis is calculated by Geometric Studio, and before the 3D models will be aligned using best fit, as well the volumes will be calculated. And on this image here, this small beam shows the shrinkage in longitudinal direction here, and it's understandable because the beam was cut at both ends by hatchets or saws. So whereas the diameter appears to have remained stable. During the preservation, the beam lost nearly 5% of its volume, and our conservators are really happy with this value. By contrast, this blank here shows a clear torsion at the right side. Also, it's such of this deformation. Although the volume is being nearly identical, so a deformation does not indicate a loss of volume in any case. So it's important that the change of volume and the deviation analysis have to be considered together, because the volume has become only another shape. Until now, 175 timbers were scanned twice. The other 1,000 are still waiting for the process, so we have a lot of work for the next years. And here you see an example of the results of the excavation of Niederpöbel called NPP-02. Mostly our conservators could have been saved more than 90% of volume. All the results are here in this. This is 90%, this is 100%. Of course, we have some outliers there because of the success directly depends on the conservation status. We have a handful of finds which are showing so massive deformations that you don't need any deviation analysis if you see the find with your eyes. So it's clear that something happened with it. Another project is the monitoring of a huge 3D print in the State Museum of Archaeology in Chemnitz. It is a replica of a cenotaph of Ybrecht von Kreutsch, which is a really important person in the medieval history of Saxony. And you should know that the original cenotaph is located in a church in the south of Leipzig, in a small town of Pegau. It's obviously that the church committee was not so impressed giving the tombstone to the museum as a permanent loan. So this is a decision was to scan and to print the tombstone in original size. But it was not scanned, the original one, but another copy, which is located in the Germanisches Nationalmuseum in Nuremberg, because this thing has preserved color information. And here you see a colleague who is scanning the original one at the church in Pegau. And an additional question was, how accurate are the copies in comparison to the original cenotaph? Because the other copy is from the 1817 or so. With a weight of nearly 400 kilos, the 3D print is a real copy of the original one. So, contrary to the image you've seen on the slide before, the print is mounted in an upright position. In the first time after the opening of the exhibition, there was no installation to support the weight. So, strong tension forces affected the geometry, and it was decided to monitor the 3D print in regular intervals. So, but let us take a look first on the comparison between the three data sets. For that, we performed the best fit, as you heard before, where the Pegau model, the original one, is our reference, followed by the deviation analysis in Geometric Studio. And as expected, the new 3D print rarely shows any deviations to the Nuremberg model, which was the reference for the printing. It appears quite differently if we take a look at the results of the comparisons between Pegau Nuremberg, which is the middle one, and Pegau 3D print here. It's a form of deflection which can caused by the different mountings. Adding to this, the original tombstone is broken in the area of the feet. The part was removed sometimes in the past for conservation reasons, so it's clear that deviations in the bottom area must be considered with caution. The 3D print was made from sand, and it is freely accessible by visitors. So the museum is interested in analysis of external influences, like thousands of touches, affecting the durability. So on this slide you see a comparison between the 2016 and the 2017 data. Here we think we see a deflection to the front side. It's kind of this curvature. And again, this might be affected by the missing weight support in the first time of the exhibition. The 2018 data set is still in processing. So we will see in a couple of weeks if the deflection is getting bigger or the deformation has been stabilized. So we will see. Engineering surveying makes high demands on accuracy and the measurements itself. So if we want to use monitoring for loans, firstly, the most important fact is to have suitable devices. It's important to clarify in advance what deviations can be expected. And so if there are any lack of knowledge about the dimensions, choosing the right scanning device or method can be really complicated. The cost to benefit as well as the accuracy requirements have to be in a reasonable ratio. And of course, the available devices must have the necessary performance to ensure that we have reliable data. Second one is reference data are required. So standard changes must be known, especially organic objects are changing constantly. So you have to know what is normal and what is a significant change. so an appropriate tolerance range can be set. Surface properties have a direct impact on data quality. Best results, as you know, can be expected with matte surfaces, while glossy or transparent objects could have an enormous effect on noise and thus on final resolution. And this has to be included within the tolerance. And last but not least, the object itself should be in a stable condition, otherwise the measuring would not be possible. So in conclusion, in our cases, we are using best fit to align the 3D models. Increasing accuracy, it's necessary to set control points, but in our case, it's a difficult task because we must not set any permanent markers in or on the object. And within our exhibition, it is not allowed to set any points on the walls or so. So we rely on the best fit. The next is use the same sensor. Maybe you think about our small family in the first slide. There's a problem if you are dealing with long-term projects like our Archim Montan, because the devices are changing, software is changing, and so we have to use data from the Konica laser scanner as well from the smart scans with quite different resolutions. So the 3D models are not directly comparable, so we have to increase our tolerances. So to avoid this, use the same sensor. And if possible, the same stuff should digitize the objects, because everyone is developing its own workflow, which can have an impact on the data quality. And the experience is another aspect to it. And last but not least, the documentation of the documentation. It's the most important thing. Software and sensor settings have to be saved, and every monitoring data set or measurements are useless if no one knows how the data were produced, edited, and so on. And otherwise, it's only a pile of data garbage, I would say. So, thank you.